Doctor Who. London, 1966. Wotan has been defeated, its war machines immobilized. Dodo, the Doctor's companion in his last few adventures, has decided to leave the TARDIS, and the time machine departs without her. But unknown to the Doctor, the TARDIS has two new passengers. The young man, Ben Jackson, is dressed in full sailor's uniform and carries a kit bag. The young woman, whose name is Polly, wears a fashionable trouser suit with her long blonde hair tucked up under a matching cap. The Smugglers by Brian Hayles. Episode 1.
Good heavens!
Blimey, where did all this come from? Well, it was a police box, wasn't it?
What are you both doing in here?
You dropped your keys.
How dare you follow me into the TARDIS?
The what?
The TARDIS, sir! This is a vessel for travelling through time and space. Why did you follow me?
I'm terribly sorry if we've annoyed you, Doctor. It was my fault, I'm afraid.
But what sort of...
I stand back from those controls. Those controls are used for dematerializing.
Dematerializing? What does that mean?
You and this young lady are experiencing it. You are now traveling through time and space.
Yeah, well, make sure I get back by tea time, Doctor. I've got to get back to my ship by tonight.
Young man, it's going to be a long time before you see your ship again.
Eh?
Why? When are we going to land?
I don't know. And that's the cause of half my trouble through my journeys. I never know.
Why not?
I have no control over where I land. Neither can I choose the period in which I land in. Oh. Now, you see that scanner? That is what I call the scanner up there. We get a very good view from the outside.
Yes, I think we've landed in some sort of caves.
Yeah, well, thanks for the iMovies, Doctor. Now, if you just open these
doors... Wait, young man. We don't know where we are. We don't know if it's safe or what period we're in.
Well, look, I'll take a little bet with you, eh?
London, 1966, Fitzroy Square.
Yes, I think it's quite normal. Yes, the temperature's all right. Well, I think you can leave, but watch your step.
What a relief. You have me nervous for a minute, Doctor. Come on, then.
Oh, dear, all this distraction. And I really thought I was going to be alone again.
Outside the TARDIS, Ben can't believe his eyes.
Crikey, look!
Beyond the cave mouth, waves crash onto a beach.
Ben, I'm scared. What's happened to us?
I don't know. Maybe he's some kind of hypnotist. Pinch me.
Oh, not that hard.
Hey, wait a minute.
Ben is alarmed to see the Doctor locking the TARDIS.
What are you doing that for?
I never leave it unlocked, my boy.
Doctor, you must take it back.
I'm not going to take you back to London in the TARDIS.
Well, you refuse, eh?
My dear young man.
Well, come on, Polly, we'll find our own way back.
Well, I suppose I still have to chase after them. Quite incapable of looking after themselves.
Ben and Polly emerge from the cave onto a narrow strip of sandy beach.
Look at this.
Well, it might be if I was so pushed for time. Come on.
But it's a super place. Whee!
The Doctor watches as Polly dashes off along the shore. He eyes the rugged cliffs to one side and the incoming tide on the other, pondering.
Yes, I wonder. Yes, I wonder.
Well,
it'll be a lot nicer with a few hours in the bus stop. Well, got any idea where we are?
Looks like Cornwall to me.
Cornwall, are you sure?
Looks like it, me handsome.
Out. All I know is I've got to get back to Barracks. Come on, it'll take hours from here.
All right. Are you coming with us, Doctor?
Oh, yes, yes. You may know where you are, my dears, but not when. Oh, I can foresee oodles of trouble.
Some way along the beach, Ben and Polly spot a path up the cliffs and begin to scramble to the top. Amused, the Doctor watches them climb.
Oh, dear, I suppose I'd better follow them. See that they don't get into any harm.
Ben reaches the cliff top first and takes a good look around.
Yeah, look, it's a church!
So we are in our own time after all.
Yeah, you didn't really believe all that nonsense about past and future, did you?
We can't be too sure, my boy.
Sure, there are millions of churches like that.
Oh, good gracious, most of them have been standing there for centuries.
Yeah, well, so have we here. Come on, I've got a train to catch.
So
sorry, Doctor, but we'd better find a station. We can talk on the train.
Oh, talk on the train, child.
Reaching the churchyard, Polly examines one of the gravestones for clues to their location.
It's no use. I can't read it.
You think there'd be a few houses or something? I bet it's miles to a bus.
Well, there doesn't seem to appear any Victorian restoration. I think it could be any time after the 16th century.
Only it's not. It's good old 1966.
Well, I don't think so, somehow.
The church door is suddenly flung open. An old man steps out, brandishing what appears to be an antique flintlock pistol.
Hold fast! Okay.
Would you put that gun away?
Hold my tongue, lad!
In her trouser suit, with her hair under a cap, the man has taken Polly for a boy. Cautiously, he approaches the doctor.
You seem to be a gentleman, but why on foot with these lads as company?
Well, we stopped aside, sir, on our journey to walk along the cliffs, and unfortunately we got lost.
Thou art foreign?
No, we don't come from this part of the country.
Well, there's no more of ye than this.
No, just the three of us. You see, we are travellers looking for shelter.
And you came by road, and not from the sea?
No, sir, not by sea.
Very well. I cannot give thee shelter, but I can give thee sustenance and direction.
Thank you.
Come.
But he's a right one. What gear's he got on?
Yes, I'm afraid you're going to lose your bet, young man. That gentleman comes from the 17th century.
17th century?
Once inside the vestry, the old man offers his visitors some refreshment.
There's the brandy.
Oh, I'll just have a little water, thank you.
No, we don't touch it. I wonder if you could direct us to the nearest inn. We seek shelter.
In time. In good time. I don't know thee, do I?
No, I don't think we've met before, no.
Aye, it is true. And you've seen no others on the road? No ships upon the sea?
Nah, I didn't see a blind thing. Expecting someone, are you?
Speak when we spoke to, sir.
Well, I was only trying...
Ben. No, sir, we met nobody and saw nothing. You expecting some friends?
Avery's boys are no friends of mine. Never say that.
Avery.
You know not that name? Then you're the happier for it.
And you are expecting this Avery?
Him? Oh, he's been buried these long years past. But his spirit rides. Aye, and the dark souls of those who follow in his wake.
Was he a sailor?
Who mentioned sailor? What would I know about the sea? I but tend this church.
Are you a priest, then?
A priest? The word of God touched me too late, boy. I'm but church warden here. Name of Joseph Longfoot. Christian.
You appear to be afraid, sir. Can we help?
Be help? Against Pike's Hook? No, they cannot help.
Pike's Hook? What's that?
The blackest name I know, boy. So never say it to my face again.
Oh, your hand, sir. Are you in pain?
Nah, 'tis not. The fingers but bend, little men.
Dislocated.
The doctor has quickly grabbed Longfoot's hand and twisted the finger back into place.
Cured. Oh, you blessed hands.
Oh, 'tis not. 'Tis not, my dear chap. Have another drink. We must be on our way. Goodbye.
No, don't leave me.
Well, we must go. We've got to get back to the beach.
A beach? There is no beach. The tide will be in.
The tide?
Ah, yes, of course, I remember now. Yes. We have to wait until the tide recedes.
Come on, let's hurry.
We could, of course, stay, if you wish.
No, this is no place for gentlemen and lads. Go thy way. Go quickly while we may.
It must be in the 17th century.
Well, thank you for your diligence, sir, and the kindness of your help.
Thou art a real gentleman. Go the way quick.
Thank you.
Hey, a moment, sir. While at the inn, take care, I say. Guard thy tongue.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.